In today's session, we will be discussing a numerical example of design of IC engine piston. The question for today's session is, design a cast iron piston for a single acting 4-stroke diesel engine with the following data. Cylinder bore 200 mm, length of stroke 250 mm, speed 900 rpm, indicated mean effective pressure 0.85 MPa, maximum gas pressure 5 MPa, fuel consumption 0.25 kg per bp per hour. Assume suitable data you prepared and state the assumptions you make. The data book used for solving this numerical example is the one prepared by Mahadevan and Kai Balaveer Reddy, published by CBS Publishers and Distributors Private Limited. The title of the book is Design Data Handbook for Mechanical Engineers. The given data are capital D, the diameter of the piston, 200 millimeter, actually it is the diameter of the bore, and it should be equal to the diameter of the piston also. So the length of the stroke LS is 250 millimeter, the speed N is 900 rpm, indicated mean effective pressure IMEP, or it is also denoted as PM, is 0.85 megapascal. The maximum pressure Pmax is 5 megapascal. The specific fuel consumption M is 0.25 kilogram per BP per hour. In our first step, we determine the thickness of the piston head or the crown. The thickness of the piston is determined based on the strength as well as the heat dissipation, and the higher value is taken as the thickness. First, we determine the thickness of the piston on the basis of the strength, and the relation that is used is given as equation 18.13a in page number 409. The thickness of the piston head T1a is 0.43d square root of P by sigma d. The a in T1a represents the first method by which we are calculating the thickness. So in this relation, capital D is the diameter of the piston, that is 200 millimeter. P is the fluid pressure, that is the maximum fluid pressure, that is 5 mega newton per meter squared, that is 5 newton per millimeter squared. Sigma D is the allowable tensile stress. We assume it to be 38 mega newton per meter squared or 38 newton per millimeter squared. This value is taken assuming the material of the piston is close-grained cast iron. This value is given below the equation itself. So by substituting the values, we obtain T1A as 31.2 millimeter. Now on the second method, we calculate the thickness of the piston head based on the heat dissipation. So it is equation 18.13C, page number 409. The equation is T1H equal to D squared Q divided by 1600K into TC minus TE. Capital D is the diameter of the piston, that is 200 millimeter. K is the heat conductivity, that is 460 joules per second meter squared degree Celsius per millimeter. This value is given below the equation itself. Then TC minus TE is the temperature difference. We assume it to be 222 degrees Celsius. Since we assume that the material of the piston head is cast iron, we can assume that the temperature difference is 222 degrees Celsius. Now, small letter Q is the heat flow from gases per unit area of the piston head. This is calculated as HCV into C into M into BP divided by A. In this relation, HCV is the higher calorific value of the fuel that is used. C is the fraction of the total heat generated, that is absorbed by the piston head. M is the specific fuel consumption. BP is the power generated, the brake power generated. A is the area of the piston head. Now the assumptions that we make are, the mechanical efficiency is 80%, that is eta is 0.8. The ratio of the heat absorbed by the piston to the total heat developed in the cylinder is 0.05 or 5%. That is, C is 0.05. HCV, the higher calorific value is 44 into 10 raised to 3 kilojoules per kilogram. M is the fuel consumption, that is 0.25 kilogram per BP per hour. We convert it to kilogram per BP per second. So it is 6.94 into 10 raised to minus 5 kilogram per BP per second. Now BP is the brake power, that is the efficiency into indicated power. In order to find out the indicated power, the equation is Pm Ls An divided by 60, where Pm is the indicated mean effective pressure, that is 0.85 megapascal. Ls is the length of the stroke, that is 250 millimeter or 0.25 meter. Capital A is the area of the piston head, that is pi d squared by 4, that is obtained as 0.0314 meter squared. N is the number of working strokes. Since this is a 4-stroke engine, small letter N is capital N divided by 2, that is 900 by 2. So N is obtained as 450. By substituting the values in the relation for IP, we obtain the indicated power IP as 50.04 kilowatts. Now the brake power can be obtained as eta times IP, that is 0.8 times 50.04, or BP is obtained as 40.03 kilowatts. Now the heat absorbed by the piston head can be obtained as HCV into C into M into BP divided by A. Substituting the values, we get Q as 194,642.7 watts per meter squared. Therefore, the thickness of the piston head on the basis of the heat dissipation is obtained as 47.6 millimeter. Now, the thickness of the piston head is the higher among T1A and T1H. So that is higher among 31.2 and 47.6. So T1 is 47.6 millimeter, or we take it as 48 millimeter. In the second step, we determine whether radial ribs are required or not, and if required, what will be the thickness of the radial ribs. Since the thickness of the piston head is 48 millimeter, that is greater than 6 millimeter, the ribs are required. Now we assume that the number of radial ribs required is 4. The thickness of the ribs TR should be between T1 by 3 to T1 by 2. So that is 48 by 3 to 48 by 2, or TR should be between 16 and 24. We take a value that is between 16 and 24. So we assume TR to be 20 millimeter. So in the next step, we check whether a cup is required, and if required, what will be its radius. Now, since the ratio LS divided by D, that is length of the stroke to diameter of the piston, ratio is 1.25, which is less than 1.5, a cup is required. Now, the radius of the cup is 0.7 times capital D, that is 140 millimeter. Now, in the step 4, we determine the dimensions of the piston rings as well as the number of piston rings that is required. The assumptions that we take are, the allowable radial pressure PR on the cylinder wall is 0.03 megapascal. This value can be obtained from the table 18.9 in page number 414. The piston rings are made of cast iron, and the permissible tensile stress is 90 Newton per millimeter squared. The number of compression rings is 3, and there is one oil ring. So these are the assumptions. Now, to calculate the radial thickness of the ring, we use the equation 18.17A in page number 411. The radial thickness TR is calculated as capital D into square root of 3PR divided by sigma. So capital D is 200, PR is 0.03, and sigma is 90. By substituting, we obtain TR as 6.324. It can be taken as 6.5 millimeter. Now, the width of the ring. Actually, it is the actual thickness of the ring. H is obtained as 0.7 TR to TR. That is, the edge should be between 0.7 TR and TR. This is from the equation 18.17B in page number 411. H should be between 4.55 and 6.5, and we select a value in between. So H is taken as 5.5 millimeter. And from the equation 18.17C in page number 411, we can check whether this width is sufficient or not. In that relation, the minimum value of H is given as capital D divided by 10 times I. So capital D is the bore diameter, that is 200 millimeter. I is the number of rings, that is 3 plus 1 in this case. So H min is calculated as 5 millimeter. So obviously our selected width of the ring H is more than the minimum required H. Now we determine the gap between the free ends of the piston ring. Before assembly, the gap G1 should be between 3.5 TR and 4 TR. That is, G1 should be between 22.75 and 26. So G1 is selected as 25 millimeter. And after assembly, the gap G2 should be between 0.002D and 0.004D. That is, it should be between 0.4 to 0.8 millimeter. So we take G2 as 0.6 millimeter. Now, width of the top plant TG should be between T1 and 1.2 T1. This is from equation 18.18, page number 411. So TG should be between 48 and 57.6. So we take TG to be 50 millimeter. Now the land between the ring grooves, T land, should be H or a value that is less than H. So we take it as to be H itself. So it is 5.5 millimeter. Now in the next step, we determine the dimensions of the piston barrel. The thickness of the barrel at the top end, that is the maximum thickness of the piston barrel, T3, is given in equation 18.13D, page number 410. This is T3 is 0.03D plus B plus 4.5 millimeter, where capital D is the bore diameter, that is 200 millimeter. B is the depth of the ring grooves, that is calculated as TR plus 0.4 millimeter. So it is 6.9 millimeter. Therefore, T3 is calculated as 17.4 millimeter, or we take it as 18 millimeter. Now we calculate the thickness of the barrel at the open end, that is the minimum thickness of the barrel, T4. It should be between 0.25 T3 and 0.35 T3. This is from the equation 18.13F in page number 410. So T4 should be between 4.5 and 6.3 millimeter, and we take T4 as 6 millimeter. And in the step 6, we determine the piston length. The length of the piston L should be between capital D and 1.5 times capital D. This is from equation 18.14A in page number 410. So capital D is 200. So capital L should be between 200 and 300, and we take it as 300 millimeter itself. Now in the next step, we determine the dimensions of the piston skirt. The length of the piston skirt LS can be calculated as capital L minus TG minus H total, where capital L is the total piston length, TG is the top plant, that is 50 millimeter, H total is the length of the ring section, that is calculated as 4 times H plus 3 times T land. Since there are 4 rings, there will be 4 times H as well as 3 times T land. So H total is obtained as 38.5 millimeter. Therefore, the length of the piston skirt LS is obtained as 211.5 millimeter. Now, in the next step, we determine the dimensions of the piston bay. The assumptions that we make are the bearing pressure PB1 at the bush of the small end of the connecting rod is 15.7 meganewton per meter squared. The piston pin is made of case hardened carbon steel and the permissible tensile stress is 83 meganewton per meter squared. This value we can obtain from table 3.5b in page number 57. This value is the bending stress of the carbon steel. Now, to determine the diameter of the piston pin, we use the equation 18.15A in page number 411. The diameter of the piston pin D is given as pi D squared P max divided by 4 L1 PB. Capital D is the bore diameter, that is 200 millimeter. P max is the maximum gas pressure, that is 5 megapascal or 5 newton per millimeter squared. L1 is the length of the pin bearing, that we take as Kp times D, that is Kp is assumed to be 2, so L1 is 2 times D. The bearing pressure Pb is assumed to be 15.7 meganewton per meter squared, that is 15.7 newton per millimeter squared. So by substituting the values, we obtain small d as 5000 divided by d, or d squared as 5000. So d is obtained as 70.7, and we take the diameter as 75 millimeter. This is a higher value, and we consider the piston pin to be hollow, and this 75 is the outer diameter of this piston pin. Now, to fix the pin correctly in the piston, the pin should have a length almost equal to the diameter of the piston. So we can take the length of the piston to be near to the diameter of the piston. That is, we take the length of the piston to be 196 millimeter. Now, the bending stress in the pin can be obtained from the equation 18.16 in page number 411. It is the equation sigma b equal to fp d divided by 18 z. D is the bore diameter, that is 200 millimeter. Fp is the force on the piston, that is p max times a, that is p max is 5 and a is obtained as 5 d squared divided by 4. So fp is obtained as 157 kilonewton. Z is the section modulus, and we consider pin is hollow with an inner diameter of 50 millimeter. The outer diameter we obtained as 75 millimeter. So Z is obtained as 33.2 into 10 raised to 3 millimeter cube. Substituting the values, sigma B is obtained as 52.5 megapascal. Now, the actual bending stress acting on the piston pin is 52.5 megapascal, and it is less than the permissible value, that is 83 megapascal. Therefore, the piston pin is safe for bending. Now, to summarize, the specifications of the piston are: the material of the piston is cast iron, the diameter of the piston is 200 millimeter, thickness of piston head is 48 millimeter, thickness of ribs is 20 millimeter, number of ribs is 4, radius of the cup is 140 millimeter, the thickness of the piston ring, the radial thickness is 6.5 millimeter, the axial thickness is 5.5 millimeter, the width of the top lunge is 50 millimeter, the width of the other lunge is 5.5 millimeter, radial depth of ring groove is 6.9 millimeter, the maximum barrel thickness is 18 millimeter, barrel thickness at the open end is 6 millimeter. Length of the skirt is 211.5 millimeter. Length of piston 300 millimeter. outer diameter of piston bill 75 mm, inner diameter of piston bill 50 mm, length of piston bill 196 mm, number of compression rings 3, number of oil rings 1. Material for piston rings cast iron, material for piston pin carbon steel. And that's all. Thank you.